Welcome back students to the virtual lab demonstration. This video demonstrates determination of copper and iron from chalcopyrite ore. This is part 1. Please watch part 2 for the next experiment. I am Dr. Sujata Kasabe from ABASAHEB GARWARE College, Pune. The links for the other experiments are provided at the end of this video and also in the description box. To get the notification of next video, please subscribe, like and share the video. Aim of the experiment is determination of copper and iron in chalcopyrite. Theory: chalcopyrite ore contains mainly copper and small amount of silica. It is represented by the formula CuFeS2, that is Cu2SFe2S. The copper content in the ore is approximately 60 to 70%, iron 30%, silica 10%. The ore is soluble in concentrated HCl. The insoluble part is mainly silica, while the filtrate contains copper and iron. Chemicals: concentrated HCl, concentrated HNO3, concentrated H2SO4, 2 normal H2SO4, very dilute solution of KNO4, NH4OH 2 normal, 2 normal CH3COOH, disodium hydrogen phosphate solid, 5% KI solution, sodium thiosulfate, 0.025 normal approximate, star solution, 2 normal HCl, H2S gas, diphenylamine indicator, 1% in concentrated HCl, K2Cr2O7 solution, 0.025 normal exact, highly pure SnCl2 solution which is freshly prepared, saturated HgCl2 solution and phosphoric acid. Apparatus: silica crucible, gel dust flask, funnel, beaker, burette and 100 ml volumetric flask. Step 1: dissolution of ore. For that, weigh about 0.3 gram of ore and then transfer it in a gel dust flask. To this, add about 10 ml concentrated HCl and 3 ml concentrated HNO3. Place stem cut funnel and heat the flask in a fuming cupboard on a low flame till the ore gate dissolves. If not, add little amount of concentrated HCl and HNO3 and heat it again. Repeat the procedure till the ore dissolves. In this step, metal chloride is formed and Cu plus is converted to Cu2 plus. Now remove the burner and cool the flask thoroughly, and to it add 2 to 3 ml concentrated H2SO4. Then heat the flask again till dense white fumes of SO3 starts evolving. The H2SO4 added displaces the excess HNO3 and HCl which are volatile. Further, the chloride or nitrate formed is converted to sulfate. Excess of H2SO4 decomposes to evolve white fumes of SO3. Then remove the burner and cool the solution. Then rinse the funnel by adding 20 ml distilled water. Step 2 is estimation of silica gravimetrically. Filter the solution through Wattman number 41 filter paper. Collect the filtrate in a beaker. Transfer all the silica on the filter paper with 5 ml water every time. Wash the residue with hot water till it is free from chloride. For that, collect the sample in a test tube. Then test it with HNO3. It should be free from the chloride. If it is not, give the washing with hot water again. Test it with litmus paper. It should not turn red. If it is turning red, give the washing by hot water again. Now transfer the filtrate in a 100 ml volumetric flask and dilute it up to the mark by using distilled water. Here we have two part. A is gravimetric estimation of SiO2 and B is volumetric estimation of copper in presence of iron. So first part, estimation of silica gravimetrically. For that, take the weight of empty crucible plus lead and record it in a observation table. Then we have to incinerate the filter paper. For that, take a filter paper 41 along with the residue, fold it well and pin up it, and then incinerate it in a previously weighed silica crucible. Now keep this silica crucible on a blue flame and heat it strongly for 2 to 3 hours. Cool it well and then take the weight of silica crucible plus lead plus residue. Record it in a observation table. So this is the estimation of silica gravimetrically, part A. Observation table for the silica: weight of the empty watch glass, weight of the watch glass plus core, weight of the ore, weight of the empty crucible plus lead, weight of the crucible plus lead plus residue. So difference of these two, weight of the silica x gram. Calculation: W gram ore is equal to x gram silica. So 100 gram ore equal to x into 100 divided by W, which is equal to percentage of silica. Step 3 is the standardization of Na2S2O3 solution. For the volumetric estimation of copper by iodometric method, first part is the preparation of standard solution of 0.025 normal K2Cr2O7. For that, take the weight of K2Cr2O7 0.1225 gram on a watch glass and then transfer it in a beaker and dissolve it in a minimum amount of water. Then transfer this solution in 100 ml volumetric flask and dilute it up to the mark by using distilled water. So this is standard 0.025 normal K2Cr2O7 solution. Now transfer this solution in a same beaker so as to get homogeneous solution. Now fill the burette number 2 with this diluted solution of 0.025 normal K2Cr2O7 and burette number 1 with Na2S2O3 solution. Take by burette number 2 9 ml of the diluted solution in a 100 ml conical flask. Add to it 2 ml concentrated HCl, then 10 ml 5% KI and keep it for 5 minutes. Then titrate this liberated iodine with sodium thiosulfate solution with constant stirring till a pale yellow color appears to the solution. Now to this pale yellow color solution, add 1 to 2 ml starch. After the addition of starch, blue color appears to the solution. After this, continue the titration with same burette till the color of the solution changes from blue to green. So this is the x1 ml. Observations and observation table for the standardization of Na2S2O3. Given is 0.025 normal K2Cr2O7, which is exact. To find exact normality of Na2S2O3, burette 1 contains 0.025 normal approximately Na2S2O3 solution. Burette 2 contains 0.025 normal exact K2Cr2O7 solution. Indicator is starch, end point is blue to green, and record the reading in observation table as x1, x2 and x3 ml. Calculations: Na2S2O3 corresponds to K2Cr2O7. So N1 V1 equal to NV, N1 into X1 equal to 0.025 into 9, N2 into X2 equal to 0.025 into 10, N3 into X3 equal to 0.025 into 11. So the normality of Na2S2O3 equal to N4, which is equal to N1 into N2 into N3 divided by 3. Step 4 is the estimation of copper. For that, fill the burette number 2 with a diluted solution of ore. Then take 9 ml of this diluted solution in a conical flask. To this solution, add 5 ml concentrated H2SO4. Then add very dilute solution of K-4 drop wise till ferrous iron is oxidized to ferric iron. Add 1 to 2 drops excess. The color of the solution in conical flask requires faint pink color. Neutralize this solution by the addition of dilute ammonia, that is 2 normal NH4OH, till slight turbidity appears to the solution. Then add 3 ml 2 normal CS3COOH, and thereafter add 0.6 gram disodium hydrogen phosphate to precipitate iron as FePO4. Addition of Na2HPO4 mask Fe in the form of FePO4 precipitate. It does not allow Fe3 plus ions, if present, to take part in the reaction. Thereafter add 10 ml 5% Ki. To this solution add Na2S2O3 solution from the burette number 1 till pale yellow color appear to the solution, and then add 1 to 2 ml starch indicator. Blue color will appear to the solution. Now continue the titration with the same burette till blue color changes to white. So this is the Y1 ml, record it in a observation table. In the same conical flask, take 1 ml diluted solution and repeat the procedure. Observations and observation table for estimation of copper iodometrically. To find amount of copper, given Na2S2O3 N4, burette 1 contains 0.025 normal Na2S2O3 solution. Burette 2 contains diluted solution of ore. Indicator is starch, end point is blue to white, and record this reading as Y1, Y2 and Y3 ml. Calculations: 1 ml 0.025 normal Na2S2O3 corresponds to 0.001589 gram of copper. So Y1 ml N4 Na2S2O3 corresponds to Y1 into N4 into 0.001589 divided by 0.025 A1 gram of copper. Similarly, find out the reading for the Y2 and Y3 for A2 and A3 gram of copper. So 9 ml diluted solution contains A1 gram of copper, 100 ml diluted solution contains B1 gram of copper. Do the calculation for A2, B2 and A3, B3. Mean equal to B1 plus B2 plus B3 divided by 3 is equal to B gram of copper. So W gram ore contains B gram of copper, 100 gram ore equal to M percentage of copper. So this is part 1. Watch part 2 to see the next step of experiment. Thank you.